Hi.
Hi.
So can you tell me a bit about what you've studied and where you work?
So I finished my B Pharm. After that, I did my M Pharm, specializing in pharmacology. I've also done a PG diploma course in intellectual property rights. Did a few courses on Coursera here and there. So currently, I'm working in the pharmacovigilance field for approximately 6 years.
Okay. So any reason why you chose pharmacy?
Not really. From the beginning, I knew I wanted to work in the medical field, but I didn't want to become a doctor. So I explored a few paramedical fields and pharmacy seemed like the best choice.
Okay. So after you did your B-Pharm, did you have any work experience or?
Yeah, so after I did my B-Pharm, I wanted to pursue MS in US or overseas. So I did an internship with Serum Institute of India for about a year. And after that, I did apply for my master's. I gave my GRE. I applied for master's. I didn't get a scholarship, however, so I didn't really want to put in so much money, take a loan. So I opted for M-Pharm in India.
Okay. And like, what are the different exams or tests that one has to go through to do B-Pharm or M-Pharm in India?
Right. So usually one centralized test for M-Pharm would be a GPAT. And a lot of universities have their own entrance tests. So for me personally, I didn't give any centralized exams, which a lot of people find very weird. But I gave entrances to a few different universities. So I didn't give like a specific exam for it.
Okay. Any reason why you didn't do the centralized exam?
No reason as such. At that time, I didn't feel I was ready to sit for the exam.
Okay.
My preparation was not at par. So that's the reason I didn't opt for it.
Okay. So in order to work in, say, pharmacovigilance, since you're working in it, like, what are the different educational paths one can take to work in pharmacovigilance?
So usually for any field you within pharmacy you want to work for, except unless you have a business, a lot of people want you to at least have a master's degree. So same for pharmacovigilance, they prefer masters. Very few companies would opt B-Pharm candidates, but they're very few. So a majority of the universities would want you to have an M-Pharm.
Okay.
Majority of the companies would want you to have an M-Pharm degree.
Okay. Okay. So say for example, if a person has done just D-Pharm, then they would probably not get a job in
Probably not. Pharm D you would, but not with D-Pharm.
Okay. What's the difference between the two?
So D-Pharm is a diploma course. You don't get a proper bachelor's or a master's degree. On the other hand, Pharm D is like a doctorate of pharmacy.
Oh.
So it's like a step above B-Pharm, but not somewhere between B-Pharm and M-Pharm.
Between B-Pharm and
yeah.
M-Pharm. Okay.
A lot of people also would, you know, do master's after that, but a Pharm D degree would be equivalent to a master's, I would say.
Oh, okay. So could you tell me a bit about different job roles that one might apply for after doing B-Pharm and M-Pharm?
I would focus on the roles after M-Pharm, and since I've been working so much on my field, I would prefer concentrating on my field, because, you know, I don't want to like give out not valid information.
Yeah.
But to touch on a few, you could go into regulatory, like depending on your specialization. During your master's, you have pharmacology, you have QA and pharmaceuticals. So you could land roles close to what you have studied in regulatory affairs, or maybe like analytical chemistry, where you work in the QC departments of different pharma companies, or land a QA role, which is close to your regulatory this thing. Or so I work in pharmacovigilance, which is safety monitoring of the drugs. So this can happen during your clinical trial phases or post-marketing surveillance, what we say. So it's basically reporting to the regulatory authorities. The pharma companies would also outsource their job to us.
Mm-hmm.
We would be compiling the different submissions for the companies, and we'll kind of prepare like a dossier, compile all of it, submit it to the pharma company, they review it,
okay.
Get back to us if they have any doubts or if they want any changes made, and we give it to them in preparation that they can directly submit it to the regulatory authorities.
Okay.
So for post-market surveillance, it is to be done for monitoring the safety of the drug. Like, even if it is approved, they want to make sure that it is still safe, or they want to make sure it's safe in different populations, like pregnant people, or some person maybe overdosed on their drug, and what happened after that,
mm-hmm.
what was the effect of it, something like that.
Okay. So what sort of skills does one need to work in a job like this?
Since we deal with regulatories and a lot of writing.
So can you tell me a bit about how you landed your first job? How was your experience?
So I landed my first job by reference from my friend. She was actually my senior, who later turned out to be my friend after we worked together for a long time. So that is a good pointer. It helps out a lot, you know, being in touch with your seniors, seeing where they work. You can always ask them to drop a referral for you. So she just dropped a referral in their portal, and I got a call, landed the interview, got the job.
Okay. Any preparation that you did for it?
I would say read the job description, see what you're applying for, make sure the key phases that like are highlighted in the job description are a part of your CV,
mm-hmm.
while they screen it, and make sure you know what those phrases mean.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of questions would revolve around that. If you're a fresher, they'll ask you your basic knowledge of pharmacy. They'll test your basic knowledge of pharmacy because they know you haven't worked in the industry before, so they know you are not familiar with the concepts. So just make sure whatever you have been studying, go through everything.
Mm-hmm.
That's all you can prepare for.
Okay. So that was your first, like you tried for a job, you got it.
Yeah.
Like any failure stories or anything like that?
I actually was rejected for the job I applied for, but then I got it after I interviewed for it a second time.
Oh, okay. So like you've been working in the pharma industry for 5-6 years now. So how different is it like when you initially started out? And now that you're working after 5-6 years, what would you say the difference is?
More than the difference, I would say 5-6 years has given me a lot of exposure. Like, once you get into the field, you understand different avenues where you can work. If it's a company where they allow you to, you know, sort of have inter-project roles, like, you know, if you work on a project and there's an opening in another project, and you know, you can shift there and then come back to what you do. So such events give you a lot of exposure, and you'll understand all the different avenues where you can work.
Mm-hmm.
You'll find something more interesting, like, okay, this is what I'm doing, but that is something more interesting and I want to go work into that next. So next job you would apply with the closer kind of job description to what you want to work for.
Right.
So, you know, I would suggest, like, the first job, you can just do whatever comes your way. From that, you'll understand where you can go next.
Mm-hmm. How do you upskill yourself? Or rather, keep yourself updated with whatever is going on in the industry?
Google, and you have a lot of good courses on Coursera. You have even your company would be offering trainings. They a lot of companies usually have their own learning kind of, I don't know what it's called, but like a learning center where you can go and do, like they'll have Sigma projects and Sigma courses and all of that. So you can always keep yourself updated based on your work or whatever you're interested in.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What salary can one expect in the pharma industry and specifically in pharmacovigilance?
So to start with, if you're a fresher, you would be offered somewhere between 2.8 to 3.5. It's not an amazing salary, but it grows exponentially once you're in the field.
Okay.
That's all I would like to say.
Okay. Anything that one could do to, you know, get a better salary as time progresses?
It's how you market yourself. Like, mm-hmm. I didn't know how to do that when I was a fresher, but I've seen my friends land better salaries than me. It's all about how you project yourself, how you... Even if you don't have that much knowledge, or even if you do have that much knowledge, it's the way you project yourself to your managers and on paper.
Okay. Like what?
And how you can, you know, kind of bargain for it.
Mm-hmm.
Like I, for example, I did have some work experience before my master's. Even though it was an internship, it is a work experience. It wasn't for 3 or 4 months. I had worked for a year almost.
Mm.
And I could have landed a better salary,
hmm.
but I wasn't able to negotiate well, okay. I would say. So I couldn't. But you can work better on your negotiation skills, and it's how well you put your worth.
Okay.